The Oakland A's might move to Las Vegas. The NHL is preparing to welcome its newest franchise, the Seattle Kraken. There's a lot of expansion to be done in professional sports. It's the reason we have so many teams in the major sport leagues. But what does expansion mean? Why would leagues even bother expanding beyond what they already have? Aren't their current teams good enough for everyone? Today, we're going to answer all of those questions and more. We may even go through the expansion process to learn what it's really like to become the newest franchise of your favorite league. Expansion is when a professional sports league welcomes a completely new franchise into competition. Every league has had to go through expansion, as the NHL began with just the 6 original teams and then expanded gradually to the 32 teams that it has today. The MLB had just a handful of teams when it began, and both the NBA and the NFL have gone through expansion periods and merged with other leagues to grow beyond their original teams. Well, the common most reason to expand a professional sport league is for the money. 99% of the decisions in professional sports come down to the money. Well, to be more specific, the money generated from expansion comes from the fees that new teams have to pay to get into the professional sport league. To be admitted into a professional sport league, a new franchise will have to pay an absurd amount of money to the league. Recent payments for franchises have been at least several hundred million dollars, especially in the NHL. For example, the Seattle Kraken just paid $650 million to be the 32nd team in the NHL. The Vegas Golden Knights paid $500 million a few years ago to join the NHL and be its 31st team. The payments are usually according to the value of the other franchises in the league. So if the NFL were to ever expand, they would require new franchises to pay close to, if not more than, $1 billion to join, because relative to the rest of the league, that's how much a new team should be worth. With such a high entry fee, expansion can be an attractive option to leagues that really need a short-term cash infusion, because the expansion fee is then split amongst the current teams in the league. So in the Seattle Kraken's case, the $650 million that they just paid would be split into 31 different pieces for the 31 other NHL teams, which results in roughly $21 million per team. That $21 million could be used, at least in our current situation, to cover losses on ticket sales that teams took during COVID. The money that the Vegas Golden Knights had to pay to enter the league ended up going straight to the owners for a couple of reasons that are too complicated to get into for this particular video. All you need to know is that of the $500 million that was paid to the league on behalf of Vegas, zero of that money went to the players, which is simply just not right. The short-term infusion of cash from expansion teams is really nice for the owners, but the good times don't always last. Since all the teams in each professional league share their revenues with every other team in their league, adding another team to the revenue-sharing pot ends up hurting everyone else financially. The money pie gets a little bit bigger with more teams, but the slices of the pie, or the amount of money that each team gets, ends up getting smaller. Now, additionally, the TV contracts that leagues make with major media networks like Fox, Disney, and NBC don't increase substantially when another team is added to the pool. Maybe if a league were to add a new team to a huge media market like New York, Chicago, or LA, the value of the TV rights would increase. But adding a team in Las Vegas, Charlotte, or Portland is simply not going to move the needle enough to dramatically increase TV revenue. So ultimately, other teams aren't going to get a lot out of adding an expansion team to the mix in these smaller markets. There are other reasons not to expand, too. Portland has been on the short list of locations for if the Oakland A's ever leave Oakland. Montreal was proposed as a solution to the Tampa Bay Rays' perennial attendance problem just a few years ago. But there's a reason that these teams never move to these places. The leagues like to be able to have these cities like Oakland and Tampa Bay in their back pocket as leverage. That leverage forces cities like Oakland to use taxpayer money to finance expensive new projects like stadiums, even though the financial benefits for these cities and their taxpayers are pretty small. Nobody wants to be known as the person that let the professional sports team leave their city forever. Also, adding expansion teams is another great way to dilute the actual talent pool for teams to draw from. Adding another team in Seattle means 20-something more hockey players are going to need major league level contracts. A few dozen more players are going to need minor league level contracts for the various Seattle affiliated teams. and the value of a first-round draft pick drops a little bit more when another team gets to pick from the amateur talent pool. It doesn't always work out exactly that way because drafting is such a difficult thing to do well, but ideally, adding yet another 7 picks to the draft pool means there is less major league talent up for grabs for the other 31 clubs that they're competing against. So assuming the league has weighed all the factors and decided to expand, they can start to look for markets that would support a team. The market should have a large or growing population, an affluent local market that has the money to buy tickets, and preferably a plan for a stadium. The team should be located in a place that can build a fan base from the local community, and having a lot of people to build that fan base from is really important. That's one of the reasons why New York can support 2 teams in nearly every professional sport. Some of the more popular choices for a baseball expansion team include San Antonio, Charlotte, Portland, and Nashville, all of which are among the top 25 most populous cities in the US. Charlotte, Portland, and Nashville are all in the top 150 fastest growing cities in the United States too, which is a good sign for expansion teams. We also know that each of these cities can support professional sports teams, with Charlotte supporting an NFL team, Portland has an NBA team, and Nashville has a professional hockey team. Once the decision to expand is made by the league and the team pays their expansion fee, the new team can finally start to acquire players. A team is only part of the league once they finish paying their expansion fees, as the Seattle Kraken just did. So now the Kraken can start to acquire players via the expansion draft, the amateur draft, and through free agency. The Seattle Kraken are going to take part in their own expansion draft in June 2021. At that point, the Kraken will have the opportunity to pick 30 players, one from every NHL team except the Vegas Golden Knights. 20 of those players must play on the Kraken's major league roster, so Seattle can't just pick everyone's best young prospect. Each NHL team can protect roughly 11 players from their rosters, with some exceptions. All first and second year professional players, like the ones selected in the yearly amateur draft, are automatically protected and don't count towards the player limit. However, players with no trade clauses in their contracts must automatically be protected as part of the player limit. The expansion draft, as you can imagine, is very important to team building, because it sets up most of the team's roster for their first few years in the league. The Golden Knights did a really good job of building their roster in the expansion draft by finding players that would easily fit the coach's new system, as opposed to just picking the best player available from each team. This selection process made it so that the team could mesh together and play well right away, since the players fit the system that the Knights coach had put in place early. During the expansion draft, other teams can bargain with the Kraken, offering them picks or young players to select a player that the team can't or doesn't want to protect for various reasons. The Vegas Knights did this often during their draft, accepting high-quality picks or prospects in exchange for selecting players who were either bad or held bad contracts. The Kraken should come away with 30 or so players in this process, although most of them are going to be mediocre veterans or young players that need some more development time. That's why expansion teams can often be very bad when they start playing, as the odds to succeed are pretty low. The Knights were the rare exceptions to this rule. The Kraken will also have all 7 of their own draft picks in the 2021 amateur draft. This is usually the best chance that the team has to land young talent, which can set up their young core for future teams. And the Kraken are free to acquire free agents throughout the summer. So if the club feels like they're going to be competing in their first or second year in the league, they can sign free agents that can supplement their expansion draft selections and build a talented roster that way. Or they can choose to wait a few years, build up their talent, and then contend down the road. Not every expansion team can find success right away with their expansion draft picks. Thank you for watching this video on expansion teams. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any suggestions for future videos, please leave them in the comment section below. Thanks again, and I'll see you next time on Highly Technical Sports.